again.
Now, a special victims unit arrest in Portsmouth. A former IC Norcom High School music teacher is in handcuffs. Clarence Sykes is accused of sex crimes against a child more than 30 years ago. Jason Marks is following developments in this case. What's going on?
Yeah, Tom, 10 on your side has been working this story ever since that news broke of Clarence Sykes. We're told that these alleged abuse happened in the late 70s. At the time, Sykes was working in Lynchburg, living there also, and we're told he would visit someone here in Portsmouth, and that's when that abuse happened. Now, Sykes has been charged with taking indecent liberties with a minor. We're told the boy was only 11 at the time. Sykes was in his mid-20s. He's now 57. He did make a court appearance this morning and was released to house arrest. 10 on your side spoke with Earl Mobley, the Portsmouth Commonwealth's attorney, who said, quote, they have a very strong case against Sykes. We were told that he made statements to the police admitting that he abused that victim plus 11 others in Lynchburg. Mobley went on to say that the Portsmouth victim, who is now 46, is still in contact with Sykes and is not scared of him. The only reason why he went to police was he was concerned that Sykes might be abusing more children. Now, 10 on your side did learn that Sykes taught in Portsmouth for a total of 10 years. He was first in the school system in 1997 to 2001, where he taught right here at Norcom. He then left and came back in 2005, where he spent time at Churchland Middle School as a music teacher before transferring back to Norcom this fall. Now, we're told that both times when he was hired and also when he came back to the school system, there were extensive background checks into his background, obviously, and nothing came up. No red flags, because these were his first charges. What, no red flags that would have not allowed him to come back and teach. We're told that he was arrested last night at his home. He did make his court appearance this morning. School officials actually found out about it this morning and found out that news. They did send him a letter telling him that he was suspended without pay. He has not been fired, just suspended without pay. So meaning he was in the classroom yesterday. I did ask school officials whether parents were notified of this teacher, and they said they were not sure. They did not believe that teacher, that the parents got any sort of letter or were notified that this arrest had happened. Of course, we're going to continue to follow the details. We'll have the latest for you coming up tonight on Wavy News 10 at 6. But for now, that's the latest here in Portsmouth. Jason Marks, 10 on your side.
A story we will stay on top of. And according to the school's personnel policy, when a teacher is hired in Portsmouth, they can have misdemeanors, just not felonies, after they are hired. They are still allowed to be arrested. They just may be suspended or dismissed because of it. But nowhere is it mentioned that the teacher is required to tell the school about what happened.